All right, I'm back. Well, ready to get this shit started? So you may recall, last time, we made our way to the final dungeon, and then we got stuck and had to do some grinding. Now, I did do some grinding off-screen. So I made Mariel a jester, and then a luminary or a superstar, if you will. And I did that for one reason and one reason only: the hustle dance. Now I did make Barb a fighter for a little bit, but that was really just to do something with her. And I also got Hassan the big bow gun. Now the reason I did this is to help him with his damage, because Swordline, we're gonna be using that move a lot. Now, what I wanna do is I wanna give Ruto the flame sword. There is a reason for that. I wanna give the sword of Ramius to Barbara, and then equip the flame sword. The reason I'm taking the damage reduction is because of the effect of the Sword of Ramius, which is bi-kill. So Ruto and Hassan are going pretty much get just gonna be spamming Swordline. Mariel is going to be spamming Hustle Dance. This makes it to where Barb can use a Sword of Ramius. Now, only the first attack is affected by bi-kill. But what bi-kill does is it cuts your damage in half, but you attack four times. This means that your damage is doubled. With bi-kill, your damage is increased by another 25%. So the damage that Ruto is losing by going to the flame sword rather than the Sword of Ramius is actually not that much. Meanwhile, Hassan gets a massive boost from bi-kill. Dante, God damn it! I didn't want that! Well, guess I'm going backwards. There is no way I'm going to the next floor without without mana. No way in hell. Now, Hustle Dance is a little weaker than Heal Us, but it is free to use. It just can't be used outside of combat, while Heal Us can. Ow. If you're attacking, I want you to use double slash. It's not much damage, but it is something. Now, You know what? Tsunami. Tidal wave didn't happen. Rudo almost doesn't suck! Oh wait, doesn't she have the Thunder Sword? Where's the Thunder Sword? Sword of Thunder. Give that to Barbara. So she can do something. That. Damn Skippy. In fact, that's why I gave Barbara the Sword of Remius. Soldier? Now the reason I'm by killing Hassan first is because he does receive the most from by kill. I mean, Rudo's gaining plus, what, 40 damage? While Hassan is gaining almost plus 60. Thunder. Use it, dumbass! Thank you. probably should give Mariel another accessory. I mean, she has the passive of Long as a Dog.
Ow!
Now, I should bring up that I've never seen Swordline crit. So there is the potential that it's actually doing less damage, but I'll take the consistency over relying on a crit any day. Chemeco, you still suck. Pushes crits off the table. Oh, okay. Still not the worst thing on the face of the planet. And even before I started by killing Swordline, I never saw a crit. I've seen a miss, but I've never seen a crit. And again, I'll take the consistency over relying on a crit any day. You motherfucker. Mind killing that Killer Jack C? He's got double attack power. These guys apparently have double slash. That could get dangerous. You motherfucker. Okay, so while I'm thinking about it, you get to equip the Give Life armband. How about the silver bracelet? Nope. Wizard ring? Nope. Gold ring? Nope. Orb of Truth? Nope. So what can you use? Can't even use a speed ring. Or the meteorite armband. What can't you use? She can use them all? Okay, the extra defense will certainly help. Translation issues. Why do I get the feeling that is the room to Deathmoor? Land armor! Die, bitch! Oh wow, you're defending! And Rudo focused on the turtle that's defending! Rudo, you're a fucking idiot! And it's defending again! I'm not gonna complain about a free turn. Die, bitch. A door. It's a door. Yeah. Oh, god damn it. Then you buy kill, well. I think her using sort of thunder gives us more overall damage. What the fuck is this? The Book of Dragons! Can't be equipped. To Mordor? Time to give this a try. What's that do? Oh, the dragon class, okay. So it can't be used as an item in combat. And Swordland just missed once. That's not too bad. Really, Rudo? Really? You missed twice? Hey, Swordline's my move! Fuckhead! I should bring up that thunder won't hurt that demon. Is that the only reason I'm here? Oh, other door. That lead to nowhere. B-17 bomber. The blue bomber. Now, if only they had Metal Blade. That move was badass. Ow! You dick! Ow!
Hmm.
Carrie, you still suck! Hey, one first try. Oh, and I also made Terry a priest for out of combat healing. All right, so. What the fuck? There's a treasure there. There's a lot of treasures there. Me want. How do I get there? I mean, it is normal if you think normal is taking LSD. You dick. After I just healed. Let's delete dance and it's running us on loop. Oh wow, that's actually some pretty good damage. Okay, so I am going the right way to get to the treasures. A tiny medal. This late. Princess robe. Oh look, a mimic. This ain't gonna last long.
2. That's what you got. 2! You know what? I'll give it to Mariel, because she is our healer. Our primary healer. Okay, and from here... Could use a few more levels on Barbara. Ow! Could use a few more levels on Barbara. She gets absolutely murdered and by Mariel. RUN! One! Hey, it only took one that time! Gem Echo! One! Okay, so it's 2 for 3. Two for four. Ooh, 3 for 5. It's actually 50% today. Three for seven. Hey, 5 for 9. How do I get the feeling that's a trap? Stop murdering Barbara! A metal king sword? Is that an upgrade? And not a bad upgrade. Sun still gets the most benefit from Bi-Kill, though. Terry learned heal all. It's not going to be that useful. Ominous clouds. I'm closing in on the final boss. Up, this is only the second time I've seen a Metal King slime. Berserker. You know, for something called a berserker, he really doesn't have a good attack power. Ominous area, no music, lava, bottomless pit. Why do I get the feeling that's Deathmore? Yes. Are you serious? Seriously? Nope! Not going there! If you're gonna kill my party, you're gonna revive them. I'm not going there. That's fine, magic is pretty useless. You motherfucker. Right side, free turn. Okay, not ideal, but it is a free turn. Another free turn. I'll take it. Well then, that was actually really good timing, Mariel. And another free turn! So this guy can defend and attack. Sword of Thunder. What the fuck? You do take damage from the Sword of Thunder. Good. I get the feeling you're not susceptible to sap at all. Attacks seem very physical. Curious. Power up! Oh, God damn it. You motherfucker. Here we go again. I would think he might be susceptible to sap. No? Are you serious? He's not susceptible to sap, but he can cast Increase. Okay, you want to just go ahead and die? Now what? Motherfucker. You motherfucker! Are you fucking serious? Part of me kinda wants to, Are you fucking serious? No. Oh, you're pulling that shit! And apparently, increase doesn't affect the physical damage he deals! That's bullshit! Nope, not doing that! That's bullshit! If that's physical damage, it should be affected by my defense! That is bullshit! I hate games that change their rules! What the fuck is that? And we're poisoned. Oh, we're not just poisoned, we're toxic! You know what? Sword line. Hustle dance. And where's the antidote? We've seen this before. You know what? No, I'm not doing that. If they're gonna change their rules, I'm gonna play dirty. Thank you. Nope, not doing that. If he can't be hurt by Sap, I'm not doing that. Are you fucking serious? And yet, I can't sap him. Way to go, fuckheads! Are you fucking serious? Are you fucking serious? Tell me why I'm supposed to finish this? He can use increase without being affected by sap, so I can't damage him. And his physical attacks aren't affected by defense, so increase doesn't work to begin with. He attacks twice, can one-shot my party. Tell me why I'm supposed to finish this? So he's always gonna use upper second. I can't win this fight! I cannot win this fight! And now I can't even damage him. What about this? actually can't damage this guy. Barbara's the only one that can do anything! This is one of the worst bosses I've seen in a while, Rudo. This boss is not awesome. And now he's doubling his attack power. Attack power that I can do nothing about because physical attacks are not affected by defense. God, he doesn't have a resistance to that. A moment. Somebody's at the door.
Sorry about that. Complex management came by to upgrade the thermostat, shower heads, and faucet. Well. Heal us. Make sure we can withstand this turn. Oh, it's a free turn, okay. Or not. Of course. Why is he not attacking my tanks? You know, the people that are here to take those attacks? Hey, he only attacked once this time. Okay, you wanna go ahead and die? Of course. Of course. Of course! And he attacks three times! Are you fucking serious? Three times?! Okay, die already! Oh,
So now I'm starting half-cocked! Are you fucking serious? Right side, lock side at least works. Bullshit. I'm not stupid enough to look up, to check out any translations of this game. This game is bad! This game. No! Am I actually gonna have to save state every single turn? That's what it's looking like! One of those. I'm gonna be that guy. I apparently have to save state every single fucking turn. Thank you. bright side, he's not using upper. Nope. Now that I'm in good, at least somewhat good position. Nope, not going there. That move is not affected by defense, but when he uses bi-kill, it doubles its damage. That is bullshit. I mean, how much more do I need to fucking grind to beat this thing? Thank you. This is not the good part. Tell you that right now, this is not the good part. Nope. Okay, why is Rudo still asleep? Nope. Got resistance to pretty much everything I can do. And they're all immune to sleep. But yeah, Death Sleep has worked every time. A final boss. Oh, I get that. However, this is the final boss, and he had the ability to one-shot everyone. He should not have sleep. Is gonna work, I'm not gonna let him one-shot my party! And so far it's worked every single time! And there it is! Nope. and I've got no way to deal with it. What the fuck does that mean, Rudo? Oh, now it's Mario that's asleep. Think outside the box, you mean save state every single turn? I can do that. An in-game tool. Like what? I'm gonna be that guy. I don't care. This game is bad. Not killing my healers. I'm just gonna tell you right now, Rudo, if we don't finish this today, I'm not finishing this game. and it will be put on the banned list. Because this game is awful. And Mary is still asleep. Hey, he actually missed. And Mariel's still asleep. Because of course she is. And by the way, dangerous turns, you mean everything? She finally awakens. And then Hassan dies. Because of course they kill off somebody. Of course they kill off somebody. No, she was dead. There is no way you're targeting her. Well, at least Mariel's alive. Hmm. Nope. Not going there. Are you fucking serious? Yeah, I noticed. I ask again, what is it with RPGs and their horniness with killing certain people? What's the point of having defense and a tank and telling the player that order matters when order doesn't matter? Hey, Barbara actually lived! God damn it. Oh, now you want to attack before him. Okay, will you attack somebody other than Barbara?
Thank you.
Why is he attacking four times? Why did he just attack four times? He shouldn't be attacking four times. Ever! Well, he attacked somebody other than Barbara. Curious, does Sword of Remius help that ability? I can actually handle that too. Because even if Bi Kill doesn't affect that damage, and it doesn't, we're still out healing Heal Us. By the way, I thought it was a pattern! That fell asleep. That's not a pattern. That's actually quite random. That's not a pattern. says it couldn't wake up. All right, Mario, wake up. Mario, wake up. There we go, finally. That's actually fine. Okay, so we got one hand down. Which means the other one should be quick to follow. You have got to be kidding. Oh, not the shield of reflection. God damn it. Yeah, I'm not wasting a turn. Fuck that. Wait, did he do that before Barb went? Nope, he didn't. Thank you. Are you fucking serious? That. Right hand. I'll still dance. Sort of Remy as Hassan. And of course Barbara falls asleep. Bullshit. Well, hands are down. Oh, it's a skill, dumbass. Sword line. Hopefully Barbara will wake up sometime soon. Oh, she did wake up. Okay. Sort of Remy as Hassan.
Dance, and sort of Remy S. Rudo. What did he just do? That second move? No. Heal all Barbara. Swordline. Revive Mario. And of course he puts Barbara to sleep, by the way! And she doesn't wake up. Game, motherfucker! What's up, Hacticle? How you doing? Masarl. Who the fuck is Masarl? I don't remember that name! Oh, okay. Masarl and Kermit. Trippy. Yeah, yeah. Shut up. Roll credits!
Oh, so now I'm forced to take Chimecho. Did I just use return? I'm still waiting on him to do Dark Sun Shattered Lands. I mean, casual speedrun doesn't fucking matter. Dark Sun Shattered Lands. Or even better, Seventh Saga. Have fun. Shut up. Jet Force Gemini? What the fuck is that? Never heard of that. Seventh Saga is actually rather ambitious. Not gonna lie, it has its moments. And it also has one of the most broken spells in all of video games. Oh, you gotta be kidding. They're even gonna wall me in the ending! Go to the throne room, talk to the king. King ain't in the throne room. Come see me below. Where? You're seriously gonna wall me at the ending? Are you fucking serious? You're the nerd. You just had mashed potatoes. Go talk to the king in the throne room. Okay, king wasn't in the throne room. I'll see you below. Where? Oh. So I'm actually supposed to leave. Just roll fucking credits. And if this game wants to hurry up and send me to the credits, we can have cranberry sauce too. Or stuffing, whatever you want. I mean, we carved up a turkey with a lightsaber. We served Deathmore up with a side of mashed potatoes. Take me to the credits so I can move on and have some stuffing. Or corn. Corn's actually pretty badass. Roll credits? Roll credits? Are you seriously stalking my sister? Oh, now what? Okay. Are you telling me I gotta leave here too? I mean, this was the very first town in the game. Everything's supposed to come full circle. This should be the... apparently I'm supposed to leave. We are actually visiting every single town. Are you fucking mad? You know, in the first few Dragon Quest games, this was optional. Roll credits? How much longer? When this ending's over. I should also bring up that in Dragon Quest IV, this was automatic. You'd see a small scene of them in their town, and then you'd just leave. All nice and snappy. Shut up. and we were just fucking here. Can't wrap up your story here before going everywhere else and then back here and an ending that's already too long. Okay, roll credits. We've split up. Roll credits. Yes. Roll credits. I've lost my patience with this game. Okay, now what? What, do I need to leave again? Throne room? Okay, shut up. Oh, now what? Does it ever end? Finally! This game is terrible! It is god-awful! They wall you at every turn, and The dungeon set of this game is god-awful. One of the worst I've seen in a very long time. The base move set of your characters, god-awful. Now, the DQ5MC is still the worst. Make no mistake, this cast isn't too far behind. They stack AoE against you right from the very beginning and give you no way to combat it. They actually kill your entire party, potentially in one turn, every fight. And as we've seen on a number of occasions, random encounters. They wipe out my party before I even have a chance to get a command in. The dungeons are absolutely god-awful and don't convey at all what you're supposed to do. You know, the event triggers of Final Fantasy, they stand out. In this game, they look just like everybody else. So you have to go around the entire town talking to about 50 people to find out which one is the event trigger. And in those towns that have multiple event triggers, you gotta do that 3, 4, 5 times. Like, what? This game does a terrible job at guiding the player forward. It is not new player friendly at all. Now, I can handle that, for the most part, if the music did something. It doesn't. Is it as bad as Dragon Quest V's soundtrack? No. But it's not very good. The bosses are god-awful. Now, I can respect that this game is gigantic. Make no mistake. I can appreciate that this game is gigantic, but the random encounters, they're not creative at all. They are not creative at all. They needed to cut this game in half and put in more random encounters. More variation in their random encounters. This game is not new player friendly, and it gets very tedious very fast. Now, the backtracking. You can make a great game with tons of backtracking. For example, Final Fantasy I. Now, we're gonna see that later. So, I'm not gonna go into too much detail about that. Suffice to say that your entire quest line is backtracking in Final Fantasy I. Let's see. Dragon Quest III features some backtracking. Optional, but some. And a game that came out a year before this one, that is so legendary, they heard about it millennia before video games were even a thing. A little video game called Final Fantasy VI featured crap tons of backtracking, especially in the world of balance, but it's one of the greatest games ever made. Chrono Trigger featured crap tons of backtracking, but it's one of the greatest games ever made. This game backtracks for the sake of padding. The backtracking in this game should not exist. Now, is this game as bad as Dragon Quest VII? No, because this game's playable. But it is not good at all. And I'm not stupid enough to go to any of the remakes to find out if they improved anything. This ending needed to be about a third of what it was. Rank achieved playable. This game needed to be about half the size that it was. And your event triggers, if you're gonna populate your towns, Great! Go for it! It gives your town life! But you need to make your event triggers stand out! Final Fantasy has always done that! This game tries to be Final Fantasy, and it fails miserably! This is one of the worst experiences I've had in a very long time. And I'm not going to ban it permanently, but I am going to ban it temporarily. I do not want to play this game again. It is awful. But at least playable. As a game, it is better than Final Fantasy V. It is better than Final Fantasy XIV. It is better than Aiden Chronicles. It's better than Final Fantasy II, Final Fantasy VIII. Of course, Dragon Quest and we're still on ending. Of course, it's better than Dragon Quest VII. But it's not good at all. So this game is temporarily banned. Now, I should also bring up the translations. Now, the translations here were not on the original developers. This game was never released in the West until the Nintendo DS. To the people that made these translations, how the fuck did you fuck it up so badly? I mean, we saw in one translation that your dialogue was Hanjrudo. Hanjrudo. And in this translation, you can't even see your gold on hand. How the fuck did you fuck that up so badly? I absolutely do not recommend this game. If you must play it though, give the DS version a try. Now, again, I have no experience with that version, but at least it's an official translation. I'm just not stupid enough to go that far. Stay away from the English translations. They are bad. They are just bad. And it really does bring at least this version of Dragon Quest VI down that much more.
Bye-bye!
Not that it's a good game to begin with. Anyway, it is here that I'm going to go ahead and call it a day, but before we go, you need to make your games new player friendly. Okay, so you want iEnglish. You know what? Rudo, I think you might like this one. Let's raid. Princess VR. Currently playing Baldur's Gate 3. If you like what you see, feel free to give them a follow. And as for you guys, I will see you all on Thursday, 1 p.m. Mountain Time, for more Star Wars The Old Republic and Pokemon Emerald Sixmon Army. I will not be here tomorrow because I'm pretty sure you all know what that's all about. We at the Dragon's Den would like to wish you a happy Thanksgiving. Go enjoy yourselves with your family. Gobble up that turkey. Y'all have a fantastic day.